I didn't think that I would be in this kind of position where I am today, but yeah, just got to know where I'm from, Aotearoa.
Is it weird coming back?
Yeah, it is, but it's good to see family and friends and stuff. I didn't think I would be playing against New Zealand, the country that I thought I would be like, you know, I was aiming to play for.
You wanted to play for Black Ferns earlier in your career?
I actually played netball. Yeah, I was going towards that, but then rugby came in and yeah, my dream goal was to play for Black Ferns.
I've seen the video, it's like got over a million hits.
Yeah.
Like, what was that like, seeing that, like the reaction? Because that was pretty much in the space of a week, it got over like a million views.
Yeah, I just like woke up and I was like, is that me? Yeah. And stuff like that. I was just pretty shocked.
Do you want to describe that moment when you put that New South Wales girl on her backside?
No, I like went down and I got up and I was like, oh, what did I just do? And then whole crowd, and I was just really nervous after that. I was just trying to keep to myself. I was like, oh.
So how was that like coming back to New Zealand and been getting much grief from your family for choosing Australia over New Zealand?
No, but they're like really supportive now, and my family's been buying a lot of Aussie gears and stuff. So yeah, it's really good to have their support.
Do you still consider yourself a Kiwi?
Oh, I still have the passport, but yeah, soon won't be.
Who were like your sort of idols or people that you looked up to?
Vani Polite. She plays for the Australian women's sevens side. It's just her like leadership and the way she carries herself on the field. And like, she's really humble as well, so I want to, you know, follow into her footsteps and hopefully be as good as her. Richie McCaw. Yeah, he's just all over the place on the field, and like, yeah, he's just like Vani Polite, as I said, like humble and all.
And so how do you deal with, I don't know, people slot into your DMs or people trying to...
My dad handles that. No, I don't know,
Could you say maybe your family sort of keeps you level-headed, keeps you grounded?
Yeah. I don't really post that much and, like, I don't like to, I don't know, throw myself out there and stuff like that. I just like to keep to myself and, you know, be the same girl as I was before Brisbane Tens and before everything started.
So she brings that power punch, that running value. She's got the star power that kind of gets the other girls up when they're on the field with her. She's one of our co-captains, so she brings leadership and experience to our team, which is really important for some of our younger girls. So we're really excited to have Alysia in the team. I'm sure she'll step up for us over the weekend. Yeah, so she, obviously the Brisbane Tens is probably the one most people know, but in Australia, she's a bit of a rock star for a fair few things. Across the Aon University Series, she was a standout. She made the dream team, which is pretty exciting as a 17-year-old to get in that dream team across the series. So yeah, she's got a fair bit of pull in Australia as a superstar sevens player, so we're very lucky to have her in our team. So currently she's a development player, so on a development contract with that team. So she goes down and trains with the team in the lead up to World Series tournaments. She's still going through her residency requirements, so that comes up in about April next year. She'll be eligible to play for Australia, and I think once she gets her eligibility ticked off, she'll be straight into that team. But it's been a good learning experience for her. A couple of years training with some of the best players in the world has really, I've seen her increase her skills and her maturity and stuff like that, and I think she's probably ready now to step up to that next level.